Okay, so we're going to want to access this iPod so we can send apps to it and then have those install. So open up Cydia, and you're going to install source or package or manage or whatever. Click search and type open SSH. Open might be the top one. No, S. Open SSH, the top one. Going to click it. Going to click install. We're going to click confirm when that comes up. Confirm. It's going to do its installing majiggy. Might have me restart Springboard, actually. And if it does, I have to restart Springboard. If it does. Return to Cydia. Okay, perfect. And now you can right-click, go home. Now we have OpenSSH. So what OpenSSH actually allows us to do is, if you're a Mac user, go download CyberDuck. It's called an FTP client, which allows you to connect to what is referred to as a server. So like, if you own a website, you would FTP into that website. That's how I actually manage my website. So we're treating the iPod or iPhone or whatever you jailbroke in as a FTP client or FTP server in this case, and we're using a client to connect. So we're going to find the IP address, skip this version, remind me later, and we're going to see the IP address is 192.168.0.2. Okay, open connection, server 192.168.0.2, and the protocol is SFTP, SSH file transfer protocol. 192.168.0.2. Username is Alpine, and the password is the password is Alpine, and the username is root. Okay. Add to keychain. Connect. Please don't give me an error. Please don't give me an error. Just connect. And just a note: you have to keep your iPod on this entire time, otherwise it's going to scream at you. And we see at the bottom left-hand corner of CyberDuck, it's telling us that it's opening the STP connection. Connection open. All right, we're in the iPod. So now go and change it from its default root directory to just the home. And now that we're in the home, I've got to do a bit of exploring, and I'll come back. That was probably the fastest exploration I've ever done. Okay, so your downloads folder where Safari stuff that you would download would go is private, var, mobile, library, downloads. Okay, that's where stuff goes. So private, var, mobile, library, downloads. That's where stuff will go. So what you're actually going to do is, on the computer, go to applo.us. Fabulous. So on the iPod over here, actually, I'm going to go ahead and download DTunes, which allows us to access that folder, download music and movies and stuff like that. It's really, really cool. It's called DTunes. D-T-U-N-E-S. DTunes, right there. I'm going to click it, I'm going to hit install, and confirm. Return to Cydia. Okay. Cool, we're back. All right, we got DTunes. Let's check down here. Wait for it. DTunes and terminal, it downloads too. So DTunes, we'll open it up, and we'll... still not on applo.us. Let's try it again. Oh, we're on it. Okay. Geek modified this plugin. The answer is Cavern. C-A-V-E-R-N. Cavern. Okay. We're in. We rock, because we're awesome like that. So the iPod is actually yelling at us. DTunes. Note, if you're having connection problem with torrents, it's blah, 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 blah. Okay. And we see the print thing as we see in the FTP server. Print. It's an app I downloaded from the iPod. I was able to actually gain access. So media player, if you choose to, let's just go to search here. We're searching for music. Oh, we're in AppQLOS. Okay, I want Shazam Encore. Let's click it. It's going to be all like, nyam, 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 nyam to us. So we're just going to go down here. We're going to go, we want to download the latest version. Download it from AppSense. Apache is 5.3.5m. Download. And we see it's downloading over here. Go ahead. I'll minimize this. I'll use it later. Okay, sweet. And once this downloads, we're going to put it inside this downloads. Now back to over here. we're in this awesome website. We'll click in this spot here and let's search for M&M. I hate M&M, but you know what? So what? Okay, so yeah, let's go ahead with this song. So we'll click the file name. And it says, you want to download it for free? Type the code in this little orange square. So VQZ. We'll click this. VQZ. And I'm actually using my keyboard to do so. Click the X and download MP3. And if it asks us to do it again or says we got it wrong, oh, sweet, it worked. So now we want to download it. We have to click the file name. And it's automatically going to pop up with our little Safari download thing. This would not happen if we didn't have the Safari download thing. And we're going to hit download, and it's going to start the download. Now, it's really, really fast because we've got nice internet over here. All right, it's done. We'll go home. And now, actually, if we refresh over here, we should see... Oh, look at that. It literally just appeared. Isn't that amazing? Yes, I agree. That is amazing. So I'm going to show this the Shazam file in the Finder, and we're going to go ahead and drag that to the iPod. All right, you see it's syncing over here. It showed up on my other monitor. Great. Good news, good news. Okay. So we got the Shazam thing here, and now on the iPod, we want to install that. So we're going to go into Install Yes. We're going to go to the download section. We see Shazam. We're going to click it. We're going to click install, and I'm going to see if this actually works. Because if it does, I'm going to be... It's working! Oh my gosh. So it just did its little install thing. Right click to go home. And we see... Oh my gosh, there it is. Shazam. It worked. So isn't that amazing? We'll open up Shazam, and oh my gosh, it's the full... You have docked. Take advantage of Shazam. I'm good. Later. You have Dr. Grice. Would you like to enter car mode? Okay. Touch to Shazam. What's it do? Shazam would like to use your current location. Okay. No input. Sorry, we can't find any sound inputs. Another application might be using. No, I just have no mic plugged in right now. Okay. That's pretty cool. So we got the Shazam app. Oh yeah, we got it for free, man. Okay, so we'll open up DTunes now. We'll go to Media Player. Go to the media player, we see the M&M song, we click it, and it starts to play. I don't think this is actually M&M. Yeah, I really doubt it is, but point of concept is it worked. Edit. Trash the M&M song. Bye-bye M&M. Sorry. Done. We'll refresh over here. M&M went away. So just like that. And now you know everything that I really know on how to do the whole jailbreak thing. There's awesome themes you can get for Winterboard, and the one where you scroll and it goes continuously, that's called Infiniboard or something like that. Make sure you download Winterboard. That's a pretty important one, Winterboard. And in there, set it user wallpaper and transparent dock. Those are the two I like. That means the lock screen. It starts to play music whenever I lock it. Strange. Okay, so there's my lock screen. That's lock calendar, something like that. These are calendar events that I have. And if English exam coming up. Ugh. Okay. Thank you guys for paying attention and watching this video. Hope I didn't take up too much of your time. Remember, I have a JP Films Facebook group right here. Wait, no, where did it go? I thought I had this minimized. On Facebook, I have a JP Films group. Check it out. Make sure you check this out and subscribe. You know, I've got 93 fans. I'd love to make that 100. And my 100th fan, make sure to comment on this wall and say you're the 100th fan, and I will definitely make a shout-out to you. And speaking of shout-outs, John... Right here. He is How To Apple. This guy. He needs some subscribers. He does the same videos as me. He's pretty much like my awesomest friend ever. Who's a guy. See? I even told him. He's amazing. Sorry for the language. Yeah. He's just totally awesome. He makes great, great vids. Yeah. So go check out his stuff. Subscribe if you want. You could use it. Thank you. And thank you. And actually, no, I don't want to close you. Okay. Talk to you guys later. Bye.